Let's head now to Canberra and Federal Parliament and a new proposal to force voters to show their identification at the polling booth before elections have faced criticism. Now, the federal government says it's a bill that will clamp down on voter fraud.
But advocates say that's a very small issue and they're warning the proposal undermines democracy by making it harder for some people to even vote, as Sarah Collard explains.
I introduced the Electoral Legislation Amendment, Voter Integrity Bill of 2021.
It came out of nowhere.
Using the potential for voter impersonation and provide additional assurance to Australia's free and fair election.
A surprise bill introduced with little fanfare and little notice. And when it landed on the floor of the nation's parliament last week, it was met with shock and concern.
We've denied the right to vote by not having you enrolled. And now what we want to do is make sure you don't, when you turn up to the voting place, you don't get to exercise your right to vote in our democracy. That's what this is about. And I'm sick to the back teeth. I've been here 33 bloody years and I've never seen anything like this. It's racist, it's discriminatory, and it's all about suppression.
The federal opposition says the laws will make it more difficult for First Nations people to vote.
Many First Nations people actually don't have a birth certificate. I'm not talking about a few people, I'm talking about a lot of people. And if you don't have a birth certificate, it is very hard to get other forms of identification.
Under the proposed law, voters would need to present a form of ID, like a passport, a driver's licence, a bill or a bank card. If they don't have any ID, another voter can vouch for their identity or they can cast a declaration vote. There was seemingly little consultation. The Northern Land Council told Senate estimates it's been left out of the loop.
We were consulted and we'd just like to, you know, put on the record too that we ask that the government reconsiders this bill because we think that Aboriginal people in remote areas would be further disenfranchised.
So there's going to be a lot of questions, a lot of confusion and just frustration, and people will perhaps just disengage and walk away.
Northern Territory Labor Senator Malarndirri McCarthy is heading to Tennant Creek for a meeting with the Central Land Council. The voter ID proposal will be high on the agenda. She says the proposal comes at the same time the Electoral Commission's budget is being cut.
We need to enrol First Nations people like all Australians. We have such a low voter enrolment here in the Northern Territory. We've been hit hard with the cuts to the AEC. This is only going to disenfranchise and encourage disengagement. We don't want to see that happen. We want a democracy, a healthy democracy, and this is not the way to go about it.
Just 80% of First Nations people are enrolled to vote nationally, compared to over 96% for the wider community. In the Northern Territory and Western Australia, the rate is even lower, at less than 70%. The Prime Minister played down the concerns to journalists.
It's not an earth-shattering proposal that when you go to vote, that you should be able to say you are who you are and provide some form of identification to support that. That's an important protection for our democracy.
He promised no votes would be lost.
But not one vote we lost that is a formal vote and a real vote from a real person. Those safeguards are built into the bill.
But Larissa Baldwin from GetUp disagrees.
There are just so many barriers that already exist for our communities to get to the poll and cast their vote. Whether it's the complex preferential system, whether it's not having translation, people lining up for hours for translation. Last year, there was an automatic update done to the voting roll that took all non-normal kind of addresses in a lot of remote communities off the rolls. And so that had a disastrous impact when we were in the last federal election. There's lots of things that are taking us off. This is just another barrier that's being put in that is going to disenfranchise lots of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander voters across the country.
She's spent a lot of time at the remote polling booths and says these changes will make it harder for people to vote.
These laws being rolled out across Australia are going to have a devastating impact, and we really need to think about the people who it's going to target. People who are homeless, people who have disabilities, First Nations people who may not have ID. These are the type of people that we're going to try and stop from getting to the polls. These are the people our governments need to function for, and so on just that level, and like with and the state of our democracy and who needs to have a say in this election, we need to make it easier for people to get to the polls, not harder.
Yeah, it seems to be a problem, you know, that we shouldn't be putting barriers for our mob to be engaging in the electoral process and engaging in elections, and so much work over many decades has been done to getting more mob to vote.
Yeah, and the Prime Minister is saying it's not an earth-shattering law, but it's not an earth-shattering problem.
Yeah.
Voter fraud hardly happens in Australia at all to warrant a law to crack down on it, which will have an impact, a chain reaction that will disenfranchise people for even turning up on election day.
And I heard a good comment about it's a solution looking for a problem.
Yes.
You know, we've had so many laws made for our mob when no consultation's been done, so I think it's about time that we start the other way.
Yes, well said. Now, this is a federal law. We invited the Minister for Indigenous Australians, Ken Wyatt, onto the show to talk about this proposed law, but he was unavailable.
Yeah, it'd be great to get those concerns answered.